It's not polygamy. We're talking about polymary. It's different. It's different. It's basically without marriage.
Yeah.
So it's basically a unit, a foundation of love, and you're allowed to love more than one person.
Right.
You're allowed to be.
But that's both ways.
Has nothing to do with sex. It's both ways.
I even reject that term allowed.
Has nothing.
Yeah, right. Allowed.
But this is you're living authentically. Nobody allows. See, nobody gives you permission.
But this is the argument that goes down. Like every time I have this discussion with a woman. The first thing they say, the first thing that comes out of mouth, oh, but what about us? Are we allowed to do the same thing?
Well, because most time men, it's a one-way street. Most men talk about polygamy, and they don't talk about, you know, polyandry, which is a, you know, I don't believe in that either. I agree. It should be kind of like an open type of thing, open relationship, where people should be allowed to see who they want, you know, whatever. It's a mutual understanding.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, so...
But the reality is truth. If you deal with, if you don't lie and tell the truth and honesty, but at the same time, it's a contradiction because embedded in the collective psyche is that you gotta lie.
Exactly.
You know, people rush into things. Yeah,
you have to, in order to live authentically, you can't tell the truth. Mm-hmm. You have to manipulate. And all that, and that's really the tragedy.
That's why it's called keeping up appearances.
That's exactly
what it is. But if you think about it, women are suffering too because they're not. And most of the women who are married, they're unhappy, they're miserable themselves. Yeah. I mean, I'm just trying to keep it real because they just feel like they've been told by their mother and their mother to live a certain way, and they're conforming to the church and all this other kind. All these really weirdo ideas, and they don't understand that it's just weirdo ideas. That's popular. Mm-hmm. It's not, they're not authentic, and they feel the censoring, and that's why they're miserable, and then they project that misery on their counterparts.
But that's frustrated. Men and women.
No, and people get married, and then it doesn't work out.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I mean, it's both. That's why I said women suffer as well.
We lie, and women can't handle the truth, so we're stuck in a...
Yeah, exactly.
It's a great era.
We need to sit back in a round table and come up with negotiations and be like, listen, handle what I'm about to tell you. And I'll tell you.
Exactly.
Because the reason why we lie is because we want to be honest with you, but if we came up to you and tell you this thing, we got to hear your mouth.
Well, right.
We don't want to lose our security and foundation at all either.
It's like that said. That's something that I put up. If you're offended by my opinions, wait till you hear the ones I don't say.
Exactly. You know, so that's what it comes down to. Like, I've been with my baby moms for about, you know, she's not my wife, so that's the only thing I call her, you know, but I've been with her for going on nine years.
Mm.
My first 3 years of relationship was basically, you know, engagement. Mm. It was all that, and it was all by the book. I had curfew. You understand? I couldn't go certain places. I couldn't do certain things. It was real bad. She was Colombian old fashioned. Now, this is all because her mom was cheated on by her father. You get what I'm saying? So her mom basically, you know, grew up that way. Which around 2006, it led me into starting to be attracted to other women because I wasn't, it wasn't more or less of attraction, like sexual. It was more or less like I wasn't comfortable with my baby moms no more. Mm-hmm. So and therefore, you know, I needed somebody else to speak to. My guys would understand because they would just be like, oh, let's go to a strip bar. Let's go, you know, do this, do that. Right. So I would confide in another female. Now I went to my baby moms and told her, hey, this is what's going on, this is what it is. You don't like it, you know, you deal with it or not. Mm-hmm. So we came to, you know, terms to agreement to keep this whole foundation. So it's like, I live currently with my baby moms and 3 other women. Mm-hmm. You understand? We're all together.
Right.
You know what I mean?
And then it's beautiful.
It's a beautiful thing.
It's love.
I mean, the weird thing about it is like the public eye kind of looks at you kind of different.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because it's
nosy.
It's come on. We don't sleep.
You know what I'm saying? It's all conditioning, though.
A lot of women frown on it, but at the end of the day, they still hitting on me.
Yeah.
2 days later.
It's like, no, it's like a mama's comeback. What does that make you?
Are you, like, honestly, like, if one of these women that you're with, right, said to you, I want to see this other guy. Yeah, I want to go on a date tonight. You're going to be okay with that?
I wouldn't have a problem with that whatsoever. Mm-hmm. Especially my baby moms. Go on a date. Fall in love. Simon Venus now. Yeah, no, I don't have, not, actually, I have not whatsoever. It's everything's open, everything's honest. I don't have a problem with it. Mm-hmm. They don't have a problem with it. You know what I'm saying?
It's all about
as long as it's not none of my peoples, you know what I mean? Then that's different. You understand? Then I'm gonna have an issue with it. Mm-hmm. But outside, inside Foundation, we're very strict on how we do things. You know what I'm saying? Like everything has to be approved. Everything. Mm-hmm. Ahead of time,
that's what I like when you have your own family. It's your relationship, so
I have separate dates. We have separate times. We have dates all together.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? We eat dinner together. And the best important thing is that all four of us are employed.
Right.
So that's like quadruple salary. People don't think about that.
The benefits, right?
You understand about the real benefits.
But I think the most profound benefit that usually gets lost is the children.
Yeah.
The children have so much love and so much support. You should see how the children are raised in houses like this. They have a lot of love.
My kids have a lot more support. I've never been on the honor roll in my life. My kids are honor roll. They're very educated. Yeah. They don't even see. Sometimes I look at them, I'm like, do something wrong.
Oh, yeah.
it's like me and my baby mom's, you know, like next week I'm going to North Carolina, she works, the daycare is closed.
Right.
So she's like, the only place I can leave them is with, you know, my niece and nephew, which are 13 or 12. And I was like, it's about time.